and make Varanda and Hobby just a retreat back underneath that tower. We'll have to keep watching this too, because right now, like, Mist is getting so much respect over. And usually around level 3 or 4, when Hillisang's playing this matchup with the Rail, he'll look for some sort of all-in, try to either get a Summer Spell or just get some low targets on the other side, set up for some pressure early on. But Selfmade's actually invaded the top side of the map. We're going to see all out war.
Yeah, that's a ghosting in here as well. He's going to get a devastating charge off, but Selfmade flashes back in, and that's an easy enough kill for Niski and Selfmade. VTO forced away as well.
Yeah, I really don't know about that one. Of course, this is calling like, oh, VTO has this flank collapse, but in these early 2v2s, when you're spread out like that, it's very easy for Fnatic just focus fire one down. Razor pops the ghost, doesn't have a flash trying to escape over a wall or anything like that. So Selfmade gonna get away with literally murder and also a red buff.
It also means Razor doesn't have a blue buff now, will never have a red buff, is gonna be a camp behind the entire jungle path, and Looks like Selfmade is taking that topside scuttle. He's gonna get both scuttles. Selfmade's gonna be in a great position to start off this game. Doesn't have bot prior right now, but with VTO backing away, he'll have his mid laner to come over and join him whenever he so desires.
Upset went for a cheater recall, so after that third wave, back to base, gets himself a pot, a control ward, and a long sword. Places the control ward before he gets back into lane, so as not to give away necessarily. That one's going to be sitting in Tri-Brush, although it is entirely possible the Bander just checks it himself. Right here with the Sweeper, though, instead he's moving up towards the river to guarantee that Razor can get that Scuttle Crab. So between Upset looking for their early reset, Niski as well looking for a reset timer right here, Selfmade says, okay guys, it's fine, you can let Razor get a little bit back in the game, but he is still very happy with that early red steal.
Yeah, the important thing is, like, Selfmade could have been two camps ahead. Instead, he's just one camp ahead, right? Like, it's not the end of the world. He's still able to get a bit of extra gold in his back pocket, but
this guy does math, guys.
I did it wrong, but we're going to go back to it. Because he's going to be three camps ahead, instead he's just two camps ahead. It's the actual answer. I said one for some reason. VTO walked down towards the bottom lane here, not going to find anything. He has already TP'd back into his lane, so we're just using the fact. Ryze has good push early on into the Seraphine to push that wave in, and then see if perhaps he can get Hillisang or Upset to overstep. Look for that trade.
Yeah. So the thing I'm always looking at in Fnatic games is side lane volatility. And what I mean by volatility is like how frequently are we trading? Obviously, you'll rarely see like trades that go all the way to a solo kill, but in the top side, both top laners taking relatively low, Wubbo trading inside the mini waves, making use of the fury and healing he can get off of his Q, because again, that's when Selfmade is pathing towards the top side. So Wubbo's like, okay, can I hold the wave in front of my tower, get this Nard overextend, have a control ward inside the river, so maybe there's a gank opportunity. Selfmade won't go for it this time. These are the things we track specifically in top lane and bot lane for Fnatic. They love to overtrade to set up for fights within the next 60 to 90 seconds.
The question is, when you overtrade, you then overextend. And Selfmade just say, well, we don't need a trade, we just go for the dragon myself. 5 minutes on this first trade. Razor's coming in from the side as well. He's only level 5. Does have his smite available.
Wubbo has TP here, already uses his.
Oh, Wubbo doesn't have TP anymore.
There you go.
And Selfmade doesn't really have much hope here. Razor's looking in. Very quickly with that devastating charge, but the trade goes down to the bottom side. Vander oversets a little bit, uses the headbutt to try and get himself away. Selfmade, no flash, of course. Vander's going to flash away. Chases on with Realm Warp here as Niski does have the double root available and lands it straight away with that passive, but continuing in, Razor pushes forward, can't quite get the damage down with the overload, as Selfmade tanks up that Q from the right.
I'm trying to understand the thought process there for Fnatic, because Selfmade literally walked straight over the Scuttlecraft vision into the Dragon Pit to try and take that one, and I was assuming it's because Wubbo has the TP advantage, but then Wubbo pops his TP before the Dragon even gets finished off there, giving Misfits the opportunity to force them off of it. Now Hillisang in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, no way he can really go here. Does have the flash, but even when the crash down, he will flash away just in time. Vander's on his way as well, perhaps Niski will be the one to overstep. WQ combo available, Niski flashes away now, Selfmade looking for the stun there, but Razor's still on the chase, Selfmade switches to Phoenix, Cobby flashes in, look at the first kill on Hillisang, Hillisang gets the knockback, and Cobby will get the reset off that explosive shot, he can jump, right back in, a double, look at the triple as he lands right on the head of Niski, and Cobby is now popping up in this game.
Oh, that is just absolutely huge, no one else you'd rather have it on either, Cobby, the Fed Tristana, 3 kills to start off the game, he's doing everything. You know, he's dropping the support on the enemy, or the exhaust, on the enemy ADC, dealing the damage, getting those resets. But really it was Vito and Razor setting it up by almost killing off Illisang. So even though eventually it turns into Fnatic having, you know, a 3v3 here, Illisang can't really offer too much in this fight. The rotation up through River, you'll notice, is also Kavi that can get over here faster. So in this early skirmish, she shows up, it's easy peasy, gets that kill, and I've got to dive in the top side.
River goes in with the Nova, to leap away from here, and flash over to the other side. Oh, one more time, shows that enough, here it gets the 1v1! Dead as well. You said sometimes they look for the fight and the Fnatic are failing at the final hurdle as they try and make it into the playoffs.
Slash remake, guys, go next. Fnatic, they don't want anything to do with this bot. River was a complete catastrophe. Top lane, somehow, shockingly, even worse. Whippo tries to get the immediate CC onto here, but here it's going right back to his left. Whippo cannot continue to tank the tower after already using his flash to land that CC.
It leveled up off the kill as well. I mean, so made one more order would have been enough.
It hurts, man. He didn't even have to transform to get that double kill. That's the timing window they're trying to work off of, but I don't know how you recover from that mentally. Fnatic losing 5 kills in the span of about 60 seconds.
And look at that gold difference now. Here it's 700 gold ahead in the top lane. CS lead for Kavi as the Onslaught of Shadows locks up Illisang, and Fnatic can only have one direction. They've only got one button, is to go all in. They managed to get a counter kill onto Razzle here, but Kavi's working his way down and has the buster shot available. Southway looking for the stun with bow, explosive charge into busters enough. Kavi 4-0-0, a 2,500 gold lead for Misfits. And Misfits, well, they're clawing their way to that playoff spot.
Honestly, as far as, like, 8 carries go, like, Ventress Sonic in the super early game is one of the easiest champions to take over a game on. Like, all of a sudden, she's going to be wanting 1v1-ing solo laners from Fnatic. Her single target burst damage absolutely through the roof. She can crush through these turret plates as well with her EO course, and, I mean, rough man for Fnatic. Misfits looking real good here. A very important win for them. Stay strong in this playoffs race.
And I just want to remind people of what this means for the playoff picture. Fnatic are not locked in. If Fnatic end 9-9 tied with teams like Misfits, teams like Schalke, SK, Fnatic lose out on the tie breaks. They would play 7th in those scenarios. They would not make it in, even if they have the same scoreline because of our head-to-head and our tiebreaker rules. Misfits were 3-8 at the halfway point of the split. They have won so many games since then that they will continue to step up
again. Teddy, do it again, Teddy, do it again, man.
Still trying to build up that mega copy up towards the top side. Just farming up as much as he can, and Selfmade now looking for the dive. There's no minions here quite yet, but here goes Selfmade. Wallop, minions stunned up. Tank up the tower, it's up there. Who does it first? Nah, it's used by him, and there's the shutdown. Fnatic in a four-man dive. Able to get the kill, but for it, they give up 5 plates to this Tristana.
Yeah, Tristana getting everything here, but we know Fnatic, they are not able to slow down. You also, I mean, like, playstyle-wise, Fnatic never going to stop fighting this, even from a significant gold deficit. But also, looking at these two compositions, Misfits scale real good, right? Like, especially with this 4-kill Tristana already. It's not like Fnatic can just buy their time, wait, you know, cruise control through the game. You can see Kavi with a ginormous gold advantage over the rest of the competition. Even Renekton went for a straight Dirk on the first time.
That's the sweep going in. Caps is going to have the practice. LeBlanc is still coming in. The snare going down. Blue going out over the wall. Caps with the follow-up. He's going to try to go in. Caps manages to finish the job, but the rest of SK, they're looking to take the fight. Caps forced to snap back. Maybe he can peel for Yanko. Buys a bit more time. Wonder, he's tanky, but he doesn't do enough damage to turn this fight. Yankos is going to go down. 1,001. The kill's going over to the desk, going over to Yankos. His Caps, desperate to turn this, just keeps pulling back. With the chase now coming in, Jezu ready to go. The Gale Force, the ultimate, ready and available if he needs him. The Fissac going, Caps flashing out to safety. He will manage to live, but that is a big fight for SK.
Dracos, you said in draft, Blue's been a bit quiet, but there he finds a pick. He takes down Reckless, gets the shutdown, and from there the TP comes in, and SK with a numbers advantage chase on G2. They manage to pick up 3 members, force Caps' flash. They get both tower as well. SK are going to base, and they're going to get back on this map ASAP. And look at Blue with his positioning. G2 didn't know he was there, and Reckless is rotating to the play because G2 think they've caught out Tinks, but in the end, Blue's the one who's caught out Reckless, manages to one-pop him, and then there was like almost like this mechanical battle between Blue and Caps, as Caps ults over this wall. You can see, as Blue gets slept, he throws the chain just before he gets slept, and then just turned into a dash battle.
But what's important to note here
is that for Blue, and that's a battle in isolation. You talked about it. It feels like a 1v1, but it is Yanko's coming in with the ult that sets that up for Caps to get it. Yanko's finding his fourth death here, not 1001, that's 1003. I misspoke there. And Caps, going back, can contest them more, but right now SK has to be feeling good after that play.
Yeah, looks like SK will be able to pick up the dragon as well. They're dropping both waves and they're dropping mid waves, but they stopped the third dragon coming in for G2. They'll stop Soul Point, as I think Wonder almost stole it there. And I think the key thing to realize about that fight was Caps and Yankos both used their ultimates to take on Blue, and these are AoE ultimates. You want to use these on two or three members. We've seen in every fight Caps and Yankos hitting two or three members, but using all of them on Blue means that all of SK's other players can just keep running forwards, and G2 lost the fight in the end. So SK are only down, well, they are still down about 4,500 gold, 5,000 gold, but they still are fighting to stay in this game.
And LeBlanc is getting stronger. Of course, the final battle, Rogue vs. Fnatic, is next game. Important to note, if you are a Fnatic fan, you want SK to win this game. They lock your team in fourth, and Blue is now getting locked down and locked out here in the exchange. SK keeping the fight going. Wonder now has to run for the house. Has to be careful. The Kai'Sa damage. The Leona E is still going to connect. The ulti retreats. He wants more. He wants to die. But Wonder still alive. That's going to be the shutdown. Yanko's goes gold. Two members sleepy. Mickey wants to buy space. He's going to move in. It's perfectly timed. All his two members locked up. Caps here to finish the job. Caps ready to go back. The spirit unleashed in the midst of the entire team. The snapback to finish it. Now it's simply GenX next on the list. Gonna be forced to walk away from this one. He has a lot of armor, but Yone does split damage. He can't afford to take that fight.
Wunder bought so much time in that fight. It looked like G2 overextended in this dive, but Wunder just tanked him for so long. Jezzo had to invest his ult to get into the backline, and then Mickey, Caps, Reckless showed up. They turn the fight. They pick up the kills. They eventually get this top 2-2. I'm not sure if they'll get more. Blue is up in 4 seconds, but GenX is getting both.
Caps can pull back as well. They're pulling away. Tank's trying to pull Caps away, but he just uses the E to come back. GenX knocked down. That's gonna be big. And Kadril. You heard it from Betty on the desk. G2, they can take something away from Fnatic. They certainly will. Love the opportunity to do so. They're going to at least deny fourth place for now on the back of what is a fantastic team performance for this lineup.
Yeah, it looked like G2 overextended a bit here, but Wunder does take the aggro from now onwards. And now G2 do pick up LeBlanc, but Caps has to go backwards. Yankos does use the ult again, but look at Wunder. He's trying to tank them out. He's been tanking the tower this whole time. He's trying to run away. Eventually does get taken down from when Jezu ults back into the fight. And then Yankos' stopwatch buys enough time for when Caps comes back around the corner. Reckless has moved from mid, and then the Magnet Storm pulls them together. Caps and Reckless arrive, and then SK get cleaned up.
And this is what we talked about when we saw the Yone in this game, is Yone as a champion is just a basket of multipliers. So the later he goes, the more levels he gets, the more items he gets, the more and more powerful he becomes. It is insane, insane scaling on this champion. Cooldowns reduced with attack speed, damage increased. This champion is nuts once it gets to this point in the game. And 2.5 items, of course, it's matched by the LeBlanc, but still, Caps is the one you need to keep your eyes on in these fights.
Yeah, look at the CS numbers in the AD carry roll. Look at Reckless up 70 CS 25 minutes into the game. Reckless has been the, if not the standout player on G2, sitting at almost 2,500 gold ahead of Jezzy.
Flame Horizon and AD carry. That's unheard of. Like, we talked about G2 tryharding, and then that kind of fell flat in the first two games in Week 8. It felt like, hey, yeah, they might have been trying hard, but it didn't really work out. But this game is absolute dominance from G2 Esports, Gato.
Yeah, and the items, just from their carries alone, just look so scary from Caps and Reckless. The amount of strength these items have versus the amount of strength SK's carries items have. His treats looks for the Hex Flash engage, but Caps can always snap back with his E, and with G2 keeping this top push in, keeping this mid push in, means they can start Baron whenever they want. They have enough turn to get onto SK's backline with things like the Mundo running you down, the Magnet Storm from the Flash from Mickey. So how does SK respond? Tinks has the ult, that's all he has to get into the pit, but his Nash is falling quite quickly.
You group for a sleep right here. Mickey finds an engage, it's gonna be disastrous. Yanko's just instantly flashing over the wall and smiting that one. Caps ready to go in, is gonna pull back. There's two members locked up, taking his time. Mickey now going to back away. Big Scion Q, but not a lot coming for it. Is forced to ult back out to safety, but Wonder's on the chase.
Yeah, looks like he wants to chase him down. And this is such a good macro play from G2. They have mid tier 2, they have top tier 2. They push them into tier 3s at the same time, on mid, on top, then they turn and burn towards the Baron. Because SK don't have any vision, but the sleep comes out. Wunder is a bit too far to help.
But look at midwave. This is the big deal. They bought so much time. You have two members at half health. SK cannot afford to contest this midwave. And Caps just wants to keep the pressure on. G2. SK don't have any room to breathe. They can't even sit back in their own base and rest comfortably at this point in the game. It's 27 minutes in and G2 are ready to end. If SK misstep, this game is over.
Yeah, time is SK's worst enemy here. They were chunked out. They had to run to base. They've already lost mid inhib. G2 are going to hit onto this top inhib. Caps has the ultimate still. Yankos doesn't. SK needs to find some kind of engage. If they drop two inhibitors, G2 can just group bot. So you can see Blue trying to find something. GenX is charging the Q though. Let's miss.
Things on the side. Looking for the flank. It's a big ult. Maybe just maybe he can turn, but Reckless is still alive. Reckless is still untouched. Cap now going into the midst of the entire team. He finds the ult. Oh, it's just a wash. There's no room. They don't have the damage. They don't have the money. They don't have the members. They have nothing left. G2 taking everything from SK in this game. Blue will get one back, but it is too little. It is too late. And here in the 2021 spring season, G2 have locked first place. SK Gaming forced down into 5th and 6th in a final victory lap here for G2. They have fun in the final moments, but it'll be G2 first place in the LEC.
Yeah, we thought that the whole game would be as they're diving on the fountain. Yankos does pick up another death. He was 6-0-0, finishes 8-6 in the end, but what a...